Okay, so I thought I'd do like a commentary thing, since I might be stopping this soon, and if anyone else wants to run it, that'd be great. And this will be kind of a walkthrough, but also looking at the intricacy of the run. I think some people would notice by just casually watching it. To start off, I should probably explain the movement, which is I have WASD in my left hand and mouse in my right hand, and then two side buttons on my mouse with my thumb, and the side buttons are mapped to strafe upwards and strafe downwards. To move the quickest that you can in the game, you move in three directions at the same time. So you're accelerating forwards, strafing to the left, and strafing up at the same time, say, in this bit. Maybe. Not yet. So you go diagonally in three directions, and that combines those three vectors into a faster speed. So that's what I've got my controls mapped to, and then the weapon keys I just have on the to switch weapons, I just have 1 to 0 on the numbers. So level 1 is very easy, and on trainee you don't kill yourself with the red key like you do on other difficulties. And 3 missiles on the reactor and then you should be dead. Level 2 you start off by firing 3 shots before you move, while moving straight forwards, so that you get both doors in front of you. Then fast forward. It's frame. Shift, yeah, that's the one. Here you want to use missiles on all of these guys so that you have down towards 20 or less shields, so you can kill yourself with the red key here. I slightly fail and leave myself on 1, so you have to go and shoot the lava. That's so you can respawn after getting the red key. Still holding the red key, but you're closer to the red door, so you get that much faster than flying back around. This reactor, it's as soon as you fire the fourth missile. That's level 2. Level 3, you want to go down under these guys at the start to avoid having to kill them. Watch here. Speed test: if you get in this room, get the blue door, and get back out of this room before the door closes, you're starting to get your movement pretty well. After this, you can go over the top of that guy without having to kill him. Get the movement right. Get the red key, go back out. Start shooting at the reactor before you get to it. I'm not sure how many missiles on that reactor still. It's like you hit a direct 4 again, it would get it, but a bit more than that, kind of add with splash damage. So here you have the lifters, which in this blue key room you want to kind of take that route. Out of that path to get under them and then back around them. There are two in that room which really screw you over if you get caught by them. In any room that you're leaving the lifters in, you want to get out of the door as fast as possible. Don't get stuck on the door, or else they'll be waiting for you when you have to go back through that door in the other direction. There you... fire one missile to kill this invisible guy, and pick up a spread fire cannon, the new weapon, for the rest of until level 10. Tricky movement in that room, just to dodge any claws. Like, if you can dodge guys without shooting them, it's much... it's normally faster, obviously. So you kill this guy and this guy in front of the other door, because you'll be coming out back through it. And then hopefully when you come out the other way, here you need to pick up these mines and missiles. Oh, there we go, these mines. Come back out the other door, avoiding this invisible guy which you get stuck on. hopefully not too many pulls away at that point. Use one missile here to kill these guys slightly faster. Switch to concussion missiles. Lay some mines. All through that room I've just laid all my mines, which I have mapped to a scroll wheel actually, so you can lay them super fast. And then like four missiles on this reactor. Shoot any mines that are left here. Oh, I didn't kill any of those in them. Yeah, the mines are supposed to clear some of those out when you're flying back through there. And switch to homing missiles before you get to the start of the next level. Keep them. Fire off a couple of shots straight forwards before you move from there to open that door and kill the guy in front. Fire one homing missile and one shot at this guy to get him to come back through there and block your lines. Check the blue key and don't get stuck by the guys that spawn in the robot maker there. Now you can fire a homing missile down this hallway. I don't know if it's faster, but they're like knocking up a guy that you're going past later. Use the last homing missile on that guy, then pick up four missiles again here. Then you can let this guy come in the room and fly around him so you don't have to kill him. And then switch to the bulky cannon for the first time, because it opens doors the fastest and kills that guy before you get to him. That blue guy sometimes gets in the way and sometimes doesn't, it's random. So yeah, you open a couple of doors of the bulky cannon, the main use of it throughout the run. Switch back to the spread fire and kill this guy. Fire one missile to this guy, missile to the guy behind the exit there. And fire one homing missile round to that guy on the right. Let them block you in the way. While switching to concussion missiles to then get four shots on this reactor. Four missiles. And constant shooting. And hope the claws don't block your way out there. This is, you learn the places of the enemies, like there's normally only a couple of places they'll be, sometimes they wander around, but it depends on how fast your movement is through the level, so if you're starting, the movement will be slower and the guys will be in a different place to this, but eventually you'll get it to kind of a solid position where you'll recognise where they're going to be. That route through the first room there. Level 6. Another speed test. Open that door down there, get the blue key and get out of this door before it closes again. You're going very fast. Good movement. Nice. These Vulcan guys are the class 1 drillers, they're pretty dangerous, but it's trainees. This. What about? Come on, back out the blue door, go around to the yellow. So this is where you also need fast movement again. If you go exactly down the middle of the recording, going directions at once, then you can get back out the door without taking too much damage and it hasn't closed yet. There is an invulnerability over... there's an invulnerability right there, which you can get if you need it. But it's trainee, so not. This reactor, try and shoot nothing else. If you know that you've got five missiles on target on the reactor, you can fly to the exit. Otherwise you need to wait a bit. And if you get hit by those homing missiles coming towards you, it's much harder to aim. So if you get five missiles on the reactor just before the homing missile hits you, I stayed a bit too long there because I thought one of the missiles might have missed. It's better to make sure than to fly away and have to fly back because you don't get enough damage on it. Missiles to kill these guys and get right in their faces because you're gonna kill yourself, so you want lower shield. When you're learning the route, it's quite easy to know where you're going, apart from sections like this for me, when you're coming down into a room and then having to go in one of the four directions to the side, knowing which direction you're coming at. So I had to make notes on things like this when you're either going up or down into a room and then going to one of the four sides of the room. You can look the wrong way and get lost. Though here it's directly behind you as you're coming down that if you don't turn. And you can sneak behind this spider if you wait in front of it slightly longer than I just did there. And then here you're gonna shoot the lava as you collect the yellow key. Go back to the start, because you're right next to the yellow door at the start. And then 3 missiles in your own face at the wall while flying down here, because you're gonna do the same exactly the same thing as you collect the red key. Yeah. This leaves you with, this is your last life right now, so you have to fight the boss with no weapons and no lives. So previously, don't pick up any of these missiles in the starting room. I've been flying over them before. You want enough homing missiles to fire at the boss when you get to it, so on this last life, you pick up 5 of them here, then get to about 9 of them. Make sure to fly upwards and grab those ones there, yeah, 9 of them, and then pick up the quad lasers before getting to the boss. For some reason, well, it's probably a pretty good reason, quad lasers are the best for taking out boss robots, because as you're flying towards them, you can stack up a lot of quad lasers before they start hitting them. They do, they do greater damage per second in that regard, as opposed to any other weapon on bosses, because the bosses disappear when they start taking damage otherwise. For the difficulty of this boss, you can get a 3-cycle, or a 4-cycle I think I get here. The difficulty is making the homing missiles hit him, because they don't lock onto him. You have to put another guy, like this Red Hulk that's behind him right now, behind him, so that your homing missiles are locking onto him, but hit the boss in between. And yeah, you should also use the sound to listen which side he is, because he makes this big ticking noise. So here I maybe one homing missile or two, so I don't get enough damage on him. And I keep in mind where the exit is, so you can find out after killing him. You can, if you're in the right position, you can fly through the center pillar to get to the exit, and that lets you pick up some homing missiles, which is helpful for the next levels, but you don't need them. So here, you can carry on using quad lasers through the top of this. Just barrel right into this room, get shot by a load of Vulcan and get out. Well, I didn't know, it was crazy. Fire one homing missile to clear that lifter, because he takes a while. You can just fly straight at this Red Hulk and dodge his homing missile, or not. Then fly back out the way you came, the blue door. Same thing as you go in the yellow door, same with the yellow doors. You just fly as fast as you can forwards to get past that robot spawn. And then fly straight to the red key, ignoring the red hulk in the room again. This is trainee. Don't worry about being hit by something. I say that, but the levels coming up are still there. If you're going fast, there's in a lot of sections there's vulnerabilities and things you can help. So I fire one concussion missile at each of these guys. If you have the homing missiles from the end of the boss fight, you can use them instead. But you want 5 concussion missiles by the reactor of this level, so don't use them a lot. And you want that one homing missile that you picked up just before this room to fire at this trailer in front of the exit as you go past. So yeah, you're staying at 5 concussion missiles there, you're not using any more because you need to fire exactly 5 in this reactor, and as soon as you fire the 5th one, you can fire to the exit. Level by going up and shooting the spider. This is important that I missed for a long time when I was running this game. There's a laser upgrade just there to the right, which you have to slightly position yourself to pick up and then go over here to the left. So that helps you go through these slightly faster. Yeah, This is also because the next level is fairly dangerous. You want to also start picking up some shield so that you end this level with more than 100 shield and it carries over. If you end a level with less than 100 shield, it gives you 100. If you end it with more, it carries over. So there are a couple of shield pickups, like that one, which you don't quite see. Above this door, there's a shield pickup there. And then there's two different ways to do this blue door. This is a new thing, which I'm not sure is faster or not. You can either go to the right here and just go straight to the yellow key and pick it up, or go to the left here and there's a cloaking device. The cloaking device helps a lot with the yellow door. Because that's a room full of guys and you want to kind of sneak past them. But here I just go straight for the yellow key and hope that this room doesn't go too badly, this room up here. Fire one missile to try and kill that. Away. Get the red key and then somehow sneak back out. And you have to be quite quick down this tunnel as well, or else these lifters come and hit you in the face. And then I think it's 5 missiles on the reactor. It's just about 5 missiles on the reactor. You have to wait for a couple more laser shots after. 5 missiles on these lifters to get through them. If you're lucky, they drop some shield for next level. So this is where you get the fusion cannon. You start that level by not moving and firing 2 shots, so you get that door to open, and then you pick up the fusion cannon from the secret door there, then come back to this door and it's already open when you fight through it. Kill this spider because that'll get in the way, and this drill because that'll damage you. Then start charging. The main thing about using the fusion cannon, which you use for the rest of the game pretty much, is knowing when to start charging it, because it has different amounts of damage depending on how long you hold down fire before you release it. The greatest amount of damage it can do is if you're holding down fire until you're taking damage. Slightly past that point is the most damage it can do, which you need for killing reactors and things at some places. But here you start charging, so you can kill this Red Hulk in one shot and one missile, or if you don't quite charge enough, one shot and 2 missiles. But I didn't have any homing missiles there, so messed up and had to fire another shot. Get the blue key, another speed test if you get back out of this door before it closes. That's very tight. There's an extra shield. If you're less than 100 shield, you want to pick up. There's an extra shield just down and to the left of this. So you just nip in there and come back out. Because you need enough shield for the end of this level. Here you're looking for the 3,000 points as you fire one shot all the way down there, which I missed. Because you should take out all 3 of those guys in one shot. Which needs to be charged up slightly to kill those secondary drillers behind. Here it's another point of switching to the Vulcan Cannon so you can open doors quicker so you don't fly into the doors as they're opening. Because Vulcan Cannon, like a contact weapon, it travels faster than the other one. If you go through here, switch immediately back to fusion as you open that second door. Or the spider. Try and not miss that shot. It's quite a difficult shot actually with the weird passage in. And then start charging up again slightly earlier than I've done there to kill that guy. Kill him in one shot and one missile if you just release the fusion cannon as it starts to damage you. I'm on pretty low shield, so normally, and it's when you're on the other difficulties and when you're just starting, you come into this room down to the right of the yellow door there, where that secret door is opened. That's an invulnerability, which I used to pick up a lot, but obviously if you're going for the fastest run, then you don't pick up, which is why you need the extra shield for the end of this level. So yeah, this is pretty tight for the end of this level, because I'm on low shield. So if you're also on low shield, you want to kill that guy, which I failed miserably at. just fire a fusion shot between the grates without missing, and hopefully he doesn't shoot you if you don't stop like I do and miss. Fly around the spiders, kill these secondary lifters here, and start charging as you pass the hostage door. Dodge to the right of both of these homing missiles. Use a flare to open this door so you don't release your fusion charge. When you pick up the extra life in there, the doors to the reactor open, you can release and shoot the fusion charge to the reactor. Hopefully it one-shots it. And you have to fly backwards between those two hulks again without getting hit by more than one or two homing missiles. So that's probably the second most dangerous level of the game, in my opinion. You start level 11 by reaching the fire infusion jump 45 euros, because so there's a mine equipment. I need to charge up for a slight beam. Start charging, I guess stuck in the corner. Start charging about here to kill this guy in 2 missiles. And in one as well, start charging slightly early. The invisible guy here for an extra shield drop because the end of this level can get pretty damaging. Then I wonder if you fly into mines or not. I'll go back to this. This room you want to kill both of the guys on the left, otherwise they'll fly into in front of you when you're coming back through here. You want to get one shot through that guy and the guy behind him. Forwards. The big door, one shot to kill one of these guys. Get a quick request there. Switch to the Vulcan cannon again so you can open these doors as you get up to them without having to fly into them. Because the other weapons are slightly too slow. Normally if you're not using if you're not using the Vulcan cannon to open doors, you use a flare, which I have on F. Because you have the fusion cannon selected and that's not good for shooting doors with. So. That's what happens if you don't kill the guy, one of the guys behind in that room. He's in the way there. So here, you don't have to kill this guy, I don't know why I did, because you're cloaked, you can just fly straight past him. Switch to smart missiles. You want to pick up the smart missile that's down there that you can see on the left, which I accidentally missed. You can kill another way to kill Red Hulks because they have so much health. Is fire one smart missile and one fusion shot, and if all the smart missile blobs don't home in on something else, then you don't kill it. It's by the door, or sometimes it would have wandered up to here. Charge up enough to kill this guy in one or two missiles, and then it's very difficult when you're just doing this. So you want to charge your fusion cannon the entire time while flying down here, and hope that these mine layers don't get in the way. But if they do lay mines in the way and you're on low shield, they'll kill you very fast, because the mines do a lot of damage and they splash damage on the mine as well. So that's how you one-shot that reactor. You have one of the first points where you charge up to the maximum damage of the fusion cannon, so it looks like taking damage as soon as the screen goes yellow, and then a few seconds after you take damage, it will do maximum damage. Getting that shot is a bit difficult because the right side of the fusion cannon, if it even touches the wall on the right, it will disappear. You've got to aim slightly further left than you think then. And then one shot to make sure there are no invisible guys in the way up to this exit. The start of this level was a little tricky, so you fire a flare, fire one missile straight away, and that'll kill a driller in that bit to the left. Fire another flare to open this door, fire a fusion shot to kill that driller, and hit the Hulk in the far background there. So, until this point, you're flying only straight forward so that you have this aim. And then fire one missile through the door over here to kill the last driller, which is in that room. And hopefully, you should see a 3000 points in the top right. That's how you check these guys are dead in a lot of places. And then you're gonna kill yourself twice in this level to leave your weapons at the start, and then go far away and get the red key, and then kill yourself there, come back and get your weapons and finish the level. You start charging the fusion cannon just to damage yourself here, and hit the wall with some missiles as you fly to the red door and leave your weapons right here. Then as soon as you start, constant fire and 4 missiles just as that door is gonna open so that you kill this red hole. Get the spread fire cannon for the rest of this level. There are invulnerabilities in this room if you need to practice. So in this room there's an invulnerability to the left of that leftmost guy, there's a door with an invulnerability there. Pick up that smart missile from somewhere, I'm not sure where, but fire one smart missile on that guy, that's a way of picking him again. Pick up the mega missile there so you can kill yourself quickly at the end of this. Switch back to homing missiles so that you can use them on this guy. Switch to smart missiles, move it up to killing that guy so you can one-shot this Red Hulk again. And then that'll switch you to a mega missile, which you can kill yourself there as soon as you pick up the red key. I think you might want to adjust your weapon auto selects to be slightly different to how they are. I don't think I have much of mine changed apart from my Vulcan cannon is higher up. You'll make sure you pick up. So your weapons are left there. The main ones you want to make sure you pick up are your one mega missile, the fusion cannon, and the Vulcan cannon. That's probably all you need. Then if you're still over 100 shield, you can pick up that shield over here. That shield right there in front of you. But if you're not, it doesn't matter. Two shots, a fully charged shot and one shot on that reactor should kill it. Then this is, in my opinion, the hardest level of the game. There are two drillers either side of you here, but you try and skip past them without taking too much damage. Here, start charging as soon as you get the blue key, because there's a red hog behind this door that you're going to kill with it, and two missiles, but if you're just starting, then on the right here, where this hulk is on the right, there's a secret door behind him with a cloaking device, which should help you. Well, helps, because there are so many homing missiles. Pick up that shield there, because you're going to need it. Yeah, there's a red hog behind the door, but there's a spidey to get past. You fire one shot, hide behind yourself. Fire one shot to kill it at once. This is the optimal speed so far of, well, that I know of killing the red hogs, because there are so many in this place, you leave a lot alive. But here, there's one behind me and one in front of me. You want to kill the one in front of the yellow door. That's the way you're actually going to need to go. And you shouldn't need to kill that one for the fastest possible. Then start charging as soon as you've gone into this room, so that you can line up and shoot a shot through both of those guys. I didn't quite charge enough, so that you can die. You need a literally fully charged shot to be able to kill those in one. There's a red hulk in the top of that room which you don't kill. Yeah, fire a shot at that lifter over there, so when you're out of that door he'll block your way. And he can drop shield as well, which is... Try and kill both of those guys in one shot. Kill those, they're called secondary drillers. You need a slightly charged up shot. Here is select mega missile as you're coming down that hallway. Kill that guy and without looking into that room, fire a mega missile over the top, and that should kill everything in that room. If one of those drillers hasn't drifted into the way, which they probably do if you have slower movement. Luckily, this guy dropped two shield here, so I don't need to. There is a secret door right here, directly above me here, there's a secret door with a couple of shield in it, which you can get if you're on low shield. I didn't kill that guy, apparently. You still ignore the hulk in that room. Those hulks are supposed to be dead if you charge properly. And you ignore the hulk that just fires behind you here, so you pick up the red key. Try and dodge this missile, which is very difficult. Come back through. So here you can fire a, that was pretty cool, fire a homing missile about here that'll go on the right side of that pillar and kill the, kill that driller before you get to it so it doesn't shoot you some more. Switch back to fusion because I've been on Vulcan cannon the entire way to the red key and back because you need to open a load of doors and you don't need to kill anything. Switch back to fusion with the red door. Clear out most of this room. If you need more shield, clear out all of that room because they could drop shields. But you need to be above, I don't know, 40 shield is safe. 40 or above is safe enough to be able to one-shot this reactor, otherwise it's very difficult and you might need to switch to quad lasers just around the corner so you don't die. So you want to start charging so you get full charge before you go around this corner. And then fire a one-shot at that reactor. Get that guy. Hopefully without taking too many homing missiles from the guys in that room. You switch back to Vulcan cannon because you're going to fly all the way back through the way you went before without getting anything. So that's the most difficult level. And then fire one shot there to kill those guys. Here you want to charge immediately as soon as you spawn because you're charging to damage yourself. Rather than... Oh no, you're charging to kill this guy, so... You're killing yourself at the start of this level, so you leave all your weapons here at the red door, because the red door is right at the start, so you kill yourself to get back to it after getting the red key, which is way far, far away. For some reason, when you fire a homing missile at two guys like this, it always almost locks onto the guy behind first. So if you Fire one, it'll lock onto the guy behind. Wait till you can't see the guy behind and fire the other one. And you should kill both of those, because one homing missile kills one of those light drillers. And then lethal fusion shot and missile yourself by the red door to leave your weapons there. And you're doing the whole of this rest of the level without your weapons. One missile at this guy. Dodge this. Go down here. Yep, spread fire over here to go through the rest of this. Spread fire is pretty fast firing, so it opens doors quick enough before you get to them. Apart from that one, fire. So here's another place where I get completely lost, because you have to know which direction to come down through this door. So if you're staying completely flat here through the door, you would come down through both of these and go 90 degrees to the right to get to this guy. And then fire everything at this blue guy, because it gives you an invulnerability to go take a load of shots in the lava down here. Use that smart missile, which you might pick up. It's smart missile is normally right over here, but you don't have to pick it up. Sometimes you hit it, sometimes you don't. But the device guy can get in your way over there. Come back through to the blue door, which is a nice peaceful break. One guy. He sometimes gets in the way, sometimes flies down one of those tunnels, which is nice. Strike all the way through there. Ignore all the guys that have spawned. And fire a shot to lure this cloaked guy out, and then fly behind him. Your way through all this. Kill yourself with the red key. Make sure to get the red key before you die. That's happened a lot of times. And then you can pick up all your weapons and go to the end of the level. So this is another point where you want to one-shot the reactor with the fusion cannon. But first you can kill that cloaking device guy, because he's going to be in the way of the exit anyway, and he can drop a cloaking device. That guy is sometimes in the way there, so you kill him. And then you start charging. Wait for a full charge. Don't fire that smart missile, because I'm an idiot and now I have no smart missiles left. It doesn't do anything. But yeah, you full charging, one shot that reactor. At the start of this level you fire a fusion shot immediately. You don't have to, but it kills three guys in a row, and the points get pretty tight in this run, because you're on trainee. It doesn't give you extra points when you finish the level. And you need enough lives to be able to kill yourself in various places. You can skip that. You can fly around this invulnerability now and get it on the way back, so it lasts for slightly longer, or you can just get it straight now. It doesn't concentrate. Switch to the Vulcan cannon if you want to open that door slightly quicker. That's all one. One door for the Vulcan cannon. After killing this guy. Both shots. After killing this guy, start charging to like full charge, so that you can try and kill that red hog in one shot, because you want him to be out of the way for the end of the level. And over here, runs out back here if you get it on the way back. Charge up enough to kill this guy in one or two missiles. All the way back. Use Vulcan cannon now that you're flying back and don't need to kill him. Open the doors. Change out from Vulcan cannon when you get to this door. Fly slightly the wrong way there. Don't have to kill these guys, you can fly around this and kill that guy. Don't have to kill anything in this room, just fly in, grab the key and fly out. It doesn't matter how low your life is at the moment, because you're going to get an invulnerability to end the level. Switch back to Vulcan, because you're flying back the way you came again, through all the doors. Switch to fusion cannon immediately if you haven't killed that guy, so you can try and get another shot. I still haven't killed that guy, which is amazing. So, as soon as you collect this invulnerability up to the left, or even just before, start holding down the fusion cannon, so you can come up to that and one shot through everything to that reactor. So you only need to kill. This guy's supposed to be dead already, and then you don't need to kill any of these, just put a flare through and try and touch him that way. One shot that reactor and flex the exit. fire as soon as you start on most of the levels in case there's one in front of you. There's nothing here, just fly the blue key, fly back out again. Sometimes that blue, wherever that blue guy went, gets in the way of that tunnel. If you see him flying towards that tunnel on the way in, so if you're over here, and you see that guy flying down this tunnel that you're looking at now, give him one shot and he'll fly the other way. Otherwise he'll get in the way on the way. Come back out with the blue key, go through the blue door and shoot that guy immediately. Charge up slightly so that you can kill these three in this room faster. You can get them all in one shot. Normally it takes two shots, and for this run of course it takes three shots because you're bad. Here you can either use a smart missile, which I tried to select and realised that I didn't pick up the earlier one. And well, two earlier ones, because normally I have two smart missiles at this point. So you either need a smart missile to one-shot this Red Hulk, or you start charging sooner and hit it with this small missile. Kill some cloaking guys here, they can get in the way. There's one cloaking guy there, which can drop an cloaking device even. And there's one cloaking guy here with a cloaking device, hopefully you get one there. Because it helps you not take damage at the reactor, because next level you need some shield, or it's nice to have. But there's where you want to select smart missiles for this reactor one shot. I fail it in this run. So if you start charging just before here, you can put a smart missile exactly where I'm aiming now, and that'll kill this lifter in the way. But I fly into it here because I don't have a smart missile. And then your fully charged shot should be ready to hit this reactor, and you need to fire one concussion missile and should one shot it. Maybe switch to Vulcan Cannon to open that door, but then switch to homing missiles before you start the next level. Start charging immediately and then begin the next level so you can kill this guy if he gets in the way. Kill this guy, homing missile there and homing missile there if you want to kill one of those drillers, which you probably don't need to. Then here, to do this section quickly, if you have an invulnerability you want to last for as long as possible because you might need to fly through some mines later. So to do this section quickly, you start charging the fusion cannon as soon as you've killed this driller that you've just gone past here. And then fly to this guy to nudge him up. So now you can see three red hulks, well you can't see, but there are three red hulks directly forwards from here. And the fusion cannon goes through everything, so if you have a fully charged fusion shot, you aim it directly down the middle and kill all of them. Which I almost get killed straight. That's pretty fast. Now there's a cloaking device guys in the way there. Then this is another bit where I get lost, so you fly. If you're flying forwards, you turn 90 degrees to the right again to go up here. Because this level is symmetrical, so if you've gone the wrong way, you can't tell them until you've come around this tunnel. This is where the invulnerability will just be running out, and if you do that section fast enough, you're going to fly through some lines here. Otherwise, if there's a way to shoot them, you make too much damage. Here's the ultimate speed test. If you open this door, fly through it perfectly without hitting any walls, and collect the yellow key and fly all the way back, you can just about get back through that door before it closes. You go back where you came and fly straight into some mines because I don't want to kill myself. I don't actually, that's not part of the run. You kill those guys in one shot. Here you can go either way, I think they're pretty much the same speed. This way has one or two more claws in the way, but slightly shorter distance wise. Kill that guy, sometimes, kill this guy. Fly past, I'll kill him right back. You can shoot both of these guys in one shot if you get the angle like that. But that's pretty difficult. And then go back the way you came. And now you can decide whether you want to do the reactor with this little health or get the invulnerability, which is down there. The invulnerability is literally where you can see the start of that black and yellow stripe. There's a secret door in the floor, which has an invulnerability. Shoot some mines here. And as soon as you clear these mines in front of the red door, start charging as much as you can. Switch your concussion missile so you can shoot the reactor with it, because there are too many guys who are getting into it. I get a bit worried that there's a homing missile behind me, so I fly into that room too far. So here is On the demo, the score is slightly different to what it will be in game for some reason, but there is where you want to actually probably want to be thinking about it slightly before this, but you want to watch out for your score because you need an extra life for the next level. And I think in this run I get it literally on the last guy before I kill myself. You need to kill yourself twice on the next level, so you need your lives in the top left when you're playing it should have to say 2. You get the extra life when you're at 30,000 score, 300,000 score. So in this room is where you can pick up a few extra points if you're not near 300,000 score. You need to kill a couple of these guys. And then you want to be 4,000 off is probably the most you can be for this level. If you're 4,000 off, you can just about make it. You fire one homing missile at this guy because you can come back through there. Get stuck on these blocks very easily. Kill one of these guys because they'll get in the way when you fly back through this room. I kill both of those guys because I need the score. Those are more guys you can kill if you need the score for the next one. That's another point where I get completely lost on which way to go in that room because there's 4 doors on 4 sides and you're coming down. So learn where the blue key is. This is where you want to kill yourself the first time to leave your weapons here. So you should be charging the rocket cannon, firing concussion missiles at walls as you fly past them, and then kill yourself in this tunnel so that your weapons are easy to pick up when you come back through. And then fly through that guy, which you killed last time, except I didn't. Try a concussion missile in your own face on this guy. Try not to pick up the shield, because you don't want to run out of concussion missiles and not have killed yourself, because then it won't. And hit yourself. Don't pick up either of these shields in the wall, as you can pick up the key. And so you see, I think, that I get the extra life. I get the extra life right there. Just before I'm going to kill myself. Yeah, there it is. So make sure that you have a life there, otherwise you have to collect that key. Hopefully you haven't damaged yourself and fly all the way back to where you left your weapons. If you don't have enough lives. Your weapons go directly 180 degrees where you came from. Here's another speed test. Fly down this tunnel as fast as you can, and this guy can fire a missile into the... Well, this guy will fire a missile into that tunnel where you just came from, and you can sometimes fly into the back of that missile as you're coming back out. Sometimes you can get past it all the way. Oh, this one's fairly easy, just fly through there. You have to get into those guys slightly. Come round to the right so you can fire one shot through both of these guys. And to charge the fusion cannon to kill the reactor as fast as possible, we're going to charge it as you pass this light that's on the screen right now. Start charging there, flare that door so you don't release it. And fire your fully charged shot at the reactor here. I fire it through that guy because it one shots him as well. And that'll mean you only need one other shot. So I didn't quite charge it enough there, apparently. Or maybe I missed one. You should fire one fully charged shot and one other fusion shot just to kill that reactor. And switch to the Vulcan cannon to clear doors faster if you want to get back out. As you get back out. Here you go, 180 fire one shot down here with these guys. Open those doors with flares and kill that guy with a fusion cannon and try and fly out of that blue key room before that door closes again. Speed test. Charge up and fire one or two missiles depending on how much you charge at this guy. He fires a missile. He's facing the other way, but he fires a missile out of his butt anyway. Like, there it is. Oh no, doesn't do it this one. There's another speed test. Pick up the yellow key and try and get out of this door. That's very difficult. Before it closes again. I have one door set. Kill that guy because you're going to fly back through there and you want to be on the Vulcan cannon. And this is the maze level of the game, so you need to just learn this section. It's pretty confusing. You go to the right, go to the left, you go through this dog leg, and you go kind of left and up, and then go back to where you came. Switch to the Vulcan cannon to get back through these doors as you're not killing anything because you came this way. And then when you get to this corner, start charging. Unless you're on low health. So that hopefully you can open the red door, fire the fully charged shot on one shot, and that reactor get out before the door closes. Just... Now this level is very the most RNG level, so you want homing missiles selected just before you end that last level. They charge up as soon as you start. For this, the keys are all contained inside robots instead of just floating around. So you need to learn the starting positions of all the robots. This is the blue key robot. He starts on the left there every time, so it's random which way they fly. When they're scared, they lay a bomb and fly away, but if you know where they start and you get to them fast enough, hopefully you can one-shot them and they won't fly away. So this guy has the most health, the other two guys die instantly to any fusion shot touching them. So you need to charge up at the start to kill this guy. Hopefully you kill him there, not in this. Follow him whichever way he goes. So you want to be above, I don't know, 70 shield by the end of this level. You're tanking a lot of homing missiles in the reactor. Have 3 shots of fusion down there to open all the doors and kill this one. The yellow key guy starts right there every time. Yeah, you can see where it is. Fly through there, keep flying towards the red key. Red key guy is the hardest to find because he flies away. Very mean. So one shot on that guy, one shot on that guy, and the red key guy should be there. That's his starting position. But if you don't get there fast enough, he's somewhere in this place and you have to fly around looking for him for ages, so that's pretty bad. And then here's where you can... these guys always have a shield, these minelayers, so you want to get some shield off of them if you like. But you just fly into this, ignore all the red hawks and take all the red missiles in the back, and you just fire out these 4 shots and constant missiles into the right. That's the end. Start charging so you can kill that guy even if one of them misses. The blue key is surprisingly difficult to collect here. You have to fly all the way into that and fly back in. One shot to kill both of those, hopefully. Both of those. One shot to kill both of those, hopefully. Especially the Vulcan cannon, because there's 3 doors in line for both of them. This is where I'm not sure if collecting the cloaking device is faster or not, but I think there's a cloaking device there which I get. And then get stuck on something. And fly down here. You can shoot that guy and the guy in front of the UNK with one shot. Fly back out the way he came. And the yellow key is like 180 degrees behind you if you're kind of the yellow key, the yellow door. Fire a flare to open that door, pick up the red key, and then come back to that door and fire a fusion shot through it. You get a mega missile. Switch to concussion missiles, because it auto selects you. Start charging as you get to this door here. This is a little puzzle reactor, so when you first come into the room, the 4 doors open on the outsides. Fly into that one straight ahead of you. And then that one will open, you fly into this one on the right. And then the reactor should open, and you definitely want to kill the reactor before the doors close again, or else you have to do the hop again. So the reactor should take one fully charged fusion shot and another fusion shot if you're hitting it with missiles as well. So this is maybe the third hardest level for me, at least. Start charging pretty early. Don't pick up this invulnerability you need for the end of the level. So I used to do a death warp on this level, but in this route you don't have enough lives to kill yourself and come back to your weapons. So I just fly all the way through this level, which means you have to take much less damage. So you start charging so you can kill this guy in one shot and one disarm, hopefully don't get hit by too many things. Fly down this, 90 degrees to the left is where you want to go. This you have to have fast movement for, because you want to dodge all the homing missiles fired by these two guys, even though you're flying straight towards them, so you fly around this corner very fast. Get the blue key and fly back very fast. Open the blue door. Pick up this mega missile, 90 degrees to the left, fly down. And keep going around to the left to get the yellow key and this cloaking device very fast. Straight ahead of you after going out that door. It's the yellow door. Fire a couple of shots through there, don't fly into the mines because you'll die. You want the mega missile selected. so that you can, this tunnel's very awkward to try and hold up, so that you can fire a mega missile here, don't be too close to them, to kill only one of those. They have such a ridiculous amount of health. And then shoot the other one. You're trying to fly down this as fast as possible. It's actually harder than it looks, because no matter which way you're tricording, you'll fly into one of these lips of the rooms all around. So this is what you would skip if you did the death warp on higher difficulties or in a different route with extra lives. But you have to fly all the way back down here, otherwise. And then fly back up the way you came to the start. Get that invulnerability that was at the start. 90 degrees to the left should be the red door. Fire shots to kill those probe drillers. If you ideally want to kill them earlier than this, but I have to fire like 3 shots, which is pretty bad, so you can start charging immediately and switching to the sun, so you can kill this reactor in 2 shots, should be, if you get a fully charged shot. And then switching to catching results before the start of the next level. Flare, missile under there if you don't want to take damage from that. Missile to the right, that guy's slightly charged. Could be unlocked again for those 2 doors, but you need to kill this guy. If you squeeze yourself, if you tricord so that you're hitting the left wall on the floor, you always go past this guy without getting stuck, so. Nice. Go to the left in these sections. Then go down to the key. You don't have to kill anything here, really. You have to kill this guy, so you can go. And then you shouldn't. I start charging here because I'm expecting this guy to get in the way, but if you don't start charging, this lifter doesn't fly in your face, so you should be able to fly past him and just fire a shot at the driller instead. The other key, go to the left. You can squeeze him to the left behind this guy without having to wait to shoot him, but I got hit by the missiles. Then you switch to the Vulcan cannon to hopefully open this door and this door, and this door if this guy's not in the way. That guy flies in front of that door sometimes. Fly, the yellow door will be opposite this sign that I'm looking at now, so fly through there. Don't kill any guys in that room. Thank them. This section has so many lifters, it's ridiculous. So fire one shot straight towards the robot spawner in this direction. Fire another shot out from it in that direction. If you haven't picked up a cloaking device yet, by now there is a cloaking device in that secret door there. And then there's one cloaked guy here which you can also drop on. Then don't alert any of the guys in this room if you have as low shield as me, because shield for the end of this level. And fly back out exactly the way you came, because there'll only be more guys in the way anyways. So fire another shot at the robot maker that way, and another shot out that way. And a Vulcan guy will be there. You can lay mines if you get them in the right place, which I didn't, as you can see my mines are here. You can lay mines under that secret door on the roof, which is where he comes out of. Keep ignoring all of these guys, switch to concussion missiles and reactor with. Fly to the left so you can one shot both of those. And then start charging and 4 shots, so this room I just fly from left and then back to right again now. So 4 shots and concussion missiles on this, so fine. That's fine. And oh, you gotta, this is the first time you see the purple fusion hooks. You need to go low into this dip so that they don't shoot the fusion cannon. So you stay low. Hopefully you have enough shield to get past those drillers again. And then, so you don't have to waste time killing this guy with any health, you can shoot him and nudge him into the exit. So this is the 3rd, 4th OS level. This feels like you're on the home stretch at this point. So, yeah, you have slightly charged up shots to kill these trees and get the doors at the same time. There's you probably need the invulnerability of your gun. So here, directly to the left of me, there's a secret door with invulnerability in, which is wastes very little time to get. Because there's a bunch of drillers and stuff around this corner, which is cool. Otherwise, miss the shot, sometimes they fly together, you can get both in one. This guy, I've realised that you can just fly past, you don't have to waste time shooting. But it's more dangerous, because obviously he fires a fusion shot at you, and... but otherwise it's 400 missiles and like two fusion shots because they're so big. Here you position yourself right, that guy will fly out and you can get both of those in one shot. Then you fly straight at that homing missile and hopefully dodge it. You can pick up that shield there for safety if you're on low shield. To the right. This is where it's dangerous if you don't kill that fusion hog because you're flying straight back towards him at this point. You have to fly over him or under him and hopefully not go hit him. You have to kill this guy. If you're on low health, you really have to hope you get this cloaking device. There's a high likelihood he drops it, but sometimes he doesn't, and it's very bad. Timing missiles to kill that guy, and then switching to cluster missiles, and then start charging. And just constantly fire at this. It takes four shots to kill some missiles again. Don't accidentally fire a mega missile if you automatically switch to those. That guy at the exit, you can just nudge into the exit again and not have to kill. So here, fly down and get the blue key, which is right here, and kill that guy. And kill that guy as you're leaving the room. You need to go back to there. You can shoot those, I don't think I do anymore. They tend to just stay there and not get in the way. Shoot that guy, because you need to go through that door, and shoot this guy. And fire a shot down and get both of those. Those all need to be charged up slightly more than nothing. And then here, I don't kill any of these guys anymore, and you can kill this guy. Then switch to the bot, can get back through these doors, which I don't. That guy sometimes flies in the way, normally you need to kill him, but if you're fast enough... And that guy sometimes is in the way of the door as you're coming out here. So here is... you want to make sure you have enough shield, because you can either go right in here, tank everything, and fire a well-aimed fusion shot down here, because for some reason it's really bad. And if the fusion shots even touch any of the walls, they just disappear. Or if you have not very much shield, switch to quad lasers and just stay at the end of this and shoot down here to kill everything. You don't need to open that secret door and kill that guy, just to fire an extra shot accidentally. Switch to Vulcan to get back all the way through these doors. Don't just kill those guys anymore. Not coming back through there. That guy should be dead from the first shot, but never. So you pick up the invulnerability in that door to end the level, so... Fusion coming through the red door. One fusion shot and then missiles kill that guy. And then immediately start charging, switching concussions. This reactor takes three shots with the charge shots. Oh no, I even missed one. So that's four shots. But normally three shots and constant missiles. Then switch to half concussion missiles still for the start of the next level. Start of the next level is the second last level. My favourite designed level because you fly through these grates and then fly through the outside of them later. You want to kill yourself at the blue door, so you leave your weapons here. So, concussion missile on the wall to open yourself up. Try and kill this guy because he can get in the way later and you take a fusion shot and die. And then concussion yourself down this so you can die by the blue door. Fire some shots forwards and go find the blue key. Fire away. Damage you take here really, because you're going to kill yourself with the blue key. And you can use a lot of concussion missiles because you pick up some more. So don't bother killing this guy because he has many health, just push him back to the blue key and kill yourself. Then collect your weapons, and get the blue key and all your weapons here. That gorilla can even be there or in this tunnel. That guy. Invulnerability. This room, you'll be flying through a lot, but in trainee it doesn't matter. So if there are drillers firing loads of shots, apparently they don't kill you. Here, as you collect the yellow key, you want to shoot this door because it stays open once you've opened it once. Kill that green hulk. You'll fly in the way as you come back. Charge up to kill this guy in one or two minutes. Switch to Vulcan cannon here, what we should do. To pick up... So this is where you pick up mega missiles for the final boss. But normally I would open this door that's right in front of me. You see the secret door here. There's two mega missiles in there, so normally flying this way I open this door, and flying back I open the other door, but for some reason this time I open them both on the way back. Not sure it makes much difference. So you open this door, get two mega missiles. If I open that door to get two mega missiles. So you have full five mega missiles for the ending level. Just use a Vulcan cannon to go back all the through all the way you came. There is a cloaking device you can get there. Or you can leave, there's a cloaking device in this room which you can leave for later. There's a lot of fusion guys there, and if you get hit you're gonna die. but you shouldn't do, because you're just flying straight to this improbability. Yep. And the tennis reactor in game. You wanna fully go as fully charged as you can, and possibly fire missiles with four fire shots. No, still four. And then have mega missiles selected for the end of for the start of the next level. So the last level. Fire a flare and a mega missile straight away. Scary, if it hits that door it will kill you. go to the right. Fire a shot to open that door. So this is where you need to be fast. You can to make this invulnerability last as long as it can. So you can pick it up now, or you can go up here and get the bullet key and then pick it up on the way back to fight fusion guys to make sure it lasts long enough. But if you're fastest moving, you can pick it up now. So you want fully charged shot and one missile on this guy to kill him. And then switch to smart missiles and use one smart missile to kill that guy. One shot smart missile, one shot to kill that guy. Hopefully they don't all home backwards. See, the blob's homed backwards there to try and hit the other guy, but you don't want that. And then stay on smart missiles because you're going to kill a load of fusion hooks. That's the blue door. Kill one of those because they'll get in the way. So you want a charged fusion shot and smart missile on this guy, and then fire two smart missiles down on this guy, one there, and you can constantly fire at them with a fusion cannon. And then hopefully your invulnerability would have lasted until now. Sorry, this guy's getting away. we have mega missile selected for the final boss at this point. This is the last guy you kill in the game. There's the final boss. And as you collect the red key, switch to quad lasers because they're the best for killing boss again. So you have quad lasers and mega missiles. So here I don't have an invulnerability, so if you go into the boss room and get shot by the boss, you die. See, he's just there on the right. If you're aiming at good speed, he'll always be on the section on the right, otherwise I think slightly later he'll be on the left, the section on the left. I get this invulnerability here, and then start killing him. His shots will kill you instantly. Or, if you're learning, where am I? Yeah, there we go. After you pick up the red key, you can shoot through this door in front of me, and there's an invulnerability in that room which you can pick up before ever going towards the boss, so you feel safer, but then it runs out quicker. You have to wait and get the other one in this room anyway, as it runs out. So for the fastest, you fly in here and pick up this. You want to try and get all your mega missiles to land on him. Again, they're not homing on a boss, and they knock you back massively. You see when I fire them, yeah, massive knockback. So you want to be quite far away from him when you fire them, but without seeing another robot that they'll home into and miss him. So you're right, miss one because he disappears. I find two. Realistically, you want to land them all. I think this is quite a slow boss fight. You can get a three type from this guy as well. And all the missiles on him. There are two mega missiles in these energy sections in this room as well, which you want to pick up after you fire the first mega. If you start shooting him too quick after he's reappearing in a new section, obviously you can't see in this demo playback, but he's got the stealthed texture, and then he comes out of stealth and goes back in. But if you start shooting him too quick, then he'll disappear too fast. Sometimes if you see in the section that's just appeared, you wait slightly before shooting him, and then you get a longer time. And then you see the 5,000 or 10,000 points in the top right, and the run has ended. You go to this top exit, make sure no other... He randomly spawns any other robot in the game around him, so make sure nothing else can be shooting you while you're waiting for the final exit, so you don't die, because I'm not sure if you have 0 lives or 1 life at the moment. If you have 1 life left, then it's probably quicker to just kill yourself as soon as you kill him, if you have anything left to kill yourself with. Otherwise, just make sure you don't die before you hit the exit. I think we've been talking for flipping hours, and hopefully, when I run it, you've learned something. But yeah, I'll probably remember stuff I haven't said later, but oh well. Any comments you want, and good luck running it if you want to. Otherwise, I hope you saw that it was more difficult than it looks.